I think that's a sensible decision because we saw every angle they can see and it was utterly inconclusive. Ferry Dupree with a put in. Held up at the base there by Joe van Niekerk. Danny McFadyen competing there. You can see McFadyen and Jean Smith are going to have a real ding-dong throughout the afternoon.
Crouch and hold. Engage.
Jean Smith, who came through the junior ranks with Jake White, who coached the World Cup winning side at under 21 level for South Africa 5 years ago. This is a good shove from the Scottish pack. But there's Van Niekerk. Van Niekerk with a pick up and drive. He's held up by Hogg just short of the line. Now they want to produce it. Osterrant is there. There's Ferry Dupree.
Hands up.
Well, the drive is on the far side. Just held up short of the line. Desperate defence here from the Scots. Well, again, they think they may have got the ball down. There's a big roar from the far side. Donald Courtney calls them to their feet. Will they once again be going upstairs to pass judgment on this?
Simon.
Well, Hugh. Close. There's no doubt he had the ball in hand. Well, no, that's short, isn't it? That is short.
It's let's get the ruler out there because it looked short. He then pushed it over. It's very, very tight. They're going to have to look at this again. No, he's tackled there. So, and then he seems to make a secondary movement, but it's so, so close.
Well, that is surely short, isn't it? You can see Berger is trying to claim it from beneath all the arms and legs.
Nolo, I have a decision for you.
Yes.
You may award the try.
Thank you.
Well, he's given the try. Quite remarkable. And I don't know about that, Scott, but I think that Scott Berger is a very lucky boy on that occasion.
Well, that will be a bit of a debate. Because it looked to be just short of the whitewash. He pushed it over the line.
Well, the restart has already taken place. Clean catch from Victor Matfield on the Springboks 22. And here's that big drive again. And this time it's Scott Berger again with the ball in hand. There he is. The big drive on. They've already made 7 or 8 metres. Danny Rousseau working hard there. And well, you could see there that the Scots stepping back, and that's become quite a fashionable tactic of late. Eddie Andrews taking the ball forward. There's Jean Smith. Support from Brain Pulser. He's got Ferry Dupree outside. Dupree. There's Pulser. Pulser with Berger on his left. He can't see him. But he's up on his feet again. And Brain Pulser has crossed in the corner. We could well have seen two tries in the space of 2 minutes.
Well, that was very, very clinical from Brain Pulser. But again, we're going to have to go upstairs and see this on a replay. But it all came from the drive from the Scots kickoff.
Can you check touch and the grounding of the ball, please?
Thank you, Donald. I'll check touch and the grounding.
Well, Donald Courtney has asked again for both the grounding of the ball and whether he's in touch.
We're just seeing it here. McFadyen is under the ball. For me, that's a good enough try for Brenton Pulser, but as I said,
yes. You may award the try.
So, South Africa's most capped winger, earning his 57th cap today. Take South Africa now.
But good pressure on Dupree forces Scotland to have the scrum.
That's okay, player.
Well, Ali Hogg fumbles it out, but gets a second bite of the cherry. Hogg's lasted well. There were serious concerns about his ability to see out 80 minutes,
okay,
having picked up that hamstring injury in the Barbars game.
Okay. Move away,
taken
six.
For by Donny Rousseau. It's another turnover. And they're costly to the Scots. Jean de Villiers in space. He's looking for support. He's got Ferry inside him. Oh, and Andre Snyman is going to cross. Well, a massive gap appeared in the Scottish defence. Jean de Villiers took it. And he had men in support. First of all, Jacques Ferry. And then Andre Snyman goes through for his 10th test try.
Well, clinical finishing.
He's been Leeds' top point scorer for the last two seasons. although I'm sure part of the exodus from that club, rather disappointingly, at the end of their Guinness Premiership season.
January with a brilliant run. Through goes Dani Rousseau. Rousseau up against Patterson. Good tackle from the Scottish wing. The pressure coming from the Springboks again. Picked up by John Smith. There's January. January to Van der Vesthuizen. Good pick up from the fly half. Inside Smith. Good tackle from Nathan Hines. There's January again to Javi Datoy. There's Jan Smith. Outside to Fazzy Montgomery. Montgomery jinks his way through. It's another try for the Springboks. South Africa, they're rampant.
Our classic Springbok rugby there, fast ball in the contact, and then out to the sharpness and slickness of Percy Montgomery, who stepped his way over the line.
Controlling at the back, scrum has wheeled somewhat there. Dupree, again he's got it! Vandenberg in possession at the back. Dupree, Russell! Space to work with! One man to beat! Brett Russell! South Africa. Well, he hooks it down the middle, and Sam Tuitupa is called into action immediately. Quite a difficult man to pull down when he gets on the go. Carter. Oh, look at this! Look at this! It's South Africa have scored! Unbelievable for Ree Dupree! Scrum takes the South African eight apart. That's a little bit better. Dupree decided to go with a kick, and Brayton Paul is there! Whoa, a great try! Scrum again, Regan under pressure. Now the race is on, it depends on the bounce. It's got to be there for Jacquery. Dive, yes! Yes, yes, yes! Priyat, this is good for the chance to move it out by three to play Montgomery. So nearly through. The drive comes from Abana over the goal line. Pile in. Can they get it to ground? A try.
This fly I've got.
Trinier Dupree. Good ball for Ndungani, crowder on their feet, and it's a great cover tackle there by Sivi Vatu, who's got extreme pace. And in fact, Liam McDonald is down, and look at this, it's for Ree Dupree, who gets in for the try. He snuck around the short side. Only Tuitupa still sitting on the bench, so Ralapela still awaits his call. Now Pretorius gets it wide for Trinier. Jacques Ferry! Try time! That was a good set piece move that by South Africa. Unfortunately, the mall seemed to be collapsed. Dupree, Pretorius, de Villiers. Oh, Jacques Ferry's timed his run beautifully. And it gets.
Two occasions I've had a go. They've broken the line both times, and that time resulted in a try which has silenced the crowd.
10-6, the All Blacks lead with the first try of the game. Sivi Vatu with the ball, and really looks in very good form at the moment after coming back from injury. Soyalo and Carter.
No.
Long, high kick, and going back, taking it nicely in the end, Petri Vandenberg. Now flings a huge pass into centre field, and Pretorius. That's another poor kick from Pretorius. Easy for Major. Rodney Sotoyalo decides to go back the other way. Intercept by Abena! The burglar's back. Read it like a book.
And he did indeed. I was seeing in the line of his aim, and he saw that pass coming from Soyalo. Soyalo just hesitated a second. He was going to take it up, then he thought, I'll move it. I've got three defenders. The key was the Springbok defence.
Four, receiver.
And he's certainly the focus of attention over here, but respect. Respect for this man, rather than the whinging we get from across the Tasman.
Now knocked down again by the Springboks. The old horrors are starting to emerge again. We get three in the second half. Here's Wannenberg staying on his feet.
Now release Black.
Great show of strength there. Untidy ball.
Stay on your feet now, boys. Let go, Black. No, don't go in there. No. That's out.
And again, untidy possession, but the box have it. Looking to move it wide. Olafia. And showing great strength and determination, too.
Oh, that's fine. He's a tackler.
Good ball. Now Tina. Away it goes to Pretorius. The All Blacks are left to defend here. Here's Spies. This exciting young player. Tina going to the short side. Vandenberg.
Well, the big boys are a handful to stop this close to the line when they're running onto the ball. And so it proved. It was an excellent try, South Africa. It really was. They moved the ball well. They broke the line and scored the try.
It was marches, and the penalty will be on here for South Africa. If they don't score, it's in a kickable position. Well, it's quickly taken by Farida Pierre. Can he get it over the line? What brilliant play by the scrum half. Shut down very quickly. Now they've got numbers on the right-hand side of this ruck half. South Africa. Spies gets it away to Peterson. Lovely pass here for Matfield. Gets inside his man. Finds Peterson again. Can the youngster score? Has men with him. Matfield sizes up the options. Now they go to the right. Paulson. Oh, Swaz bangs it over the whitewash. It's try number 25.
In 1906, a South African rugby team arrived at Southampton in England for the first ever rugby tour by a team from this country to the United Kingdom and Ireland. They were captained by a man called Paul Roux.
The field in a very special jersey to commemorate 100 years of Springbok rugby. It'll be the green as you know it, but not the gold collar, rather the white collar, and a specially designed badge, which was the same kind of jersey that the team of Paul Roux played again 100 years ago.
Kuri, the blue stockings with the white hoops at the top, and just as they played back in 1906, and then they'll be playing with the blue shorts. So it's in fact a situation where they'll run onto the field and people will not be too used to seeing them running on in these colours. But I think it's a great thing that they have come up with something special just to commemorate 100 years of rugby using the Springbok badge.
And it was a very, very memorable moment playing in those jerseys in the centenary test.
Again for Ricky January, now for John Smith. Good hands by Donny Rousseau. Great offload. Francois Steyn. Steynker, he's got it.
Francois Steyn. Now, can he make something of this? Good offload to Bevan Fortein. Now, Habana. Use the pace. Use the pace. Gets inside. Gets inside again. Brian Habana.
Lucy, Steyn has read it beautifully. Has he got the time to go for a drop again? Showed what he could do. Now, will his work turn back? He's turned back, and it's over! On the outside, finds him now. Good pass for Jean de Villiers. Look on the inside, runs it to Hodgson, holds him off. Brilliant offload! Butch James gets his first try in Test rugby. Men out wide, de Villiers it is, James, nice little dab through, and a goalie! to maintain their patience here. Pretorius looks out wide at Van der Linde. CJ! Great hands! January, Pretorius looks for the drop again. Turns! Over! They've got to keep that field position. Pretorius looks, turns, it's over! January Carstens is there. John Smith to the left, and Andre Pretorius pops it over the crossbar. Drop kick number four.
In 2004, Jake White had set the team a goal of winning the World Cup. And in late 2006, his focus was still on the Webb Ellis Cup.
Steyn, Bosman, Ulefiers, Peterson on the outside. Beautiful by Bernard Ulefiers. And, well, Jakob Pretorius almost over. Vickers van Heerden swells and dives. Works it wide. Lovely timing there from Ruan Pienaar. Look at this. Go all the way. Go on your own. Go all the way. Gets it away. Albert van den Berg. Advantage to South Africa. Surely they must score here. No. Well, there he goes. Can you see it from that angle? It's short there. A try should be given, I hear them say. There we go. Good tackle by Meyer Bosman. Now Farrell gets it away. Mitchell! Consolation try for the World 15. Blind side for a big Donny Rousseau. There goes Rousseau. Goes Wilmy, and Donny Rousseau gets the try.
It was a day to remember for a pair of number twos from the Blue Bulls, Chili Boy Ralapela and Gary Buerta, whose joint efforts at captaining the Springboks for the first time resulted in victory.
In retrospect, 2006 was not the best year the Springboks could have had, considering that the World Cup was lurking just around the